Hey everyone, it's Tuesday, the 26th of May, and yes, I am surprised it's Tuesday because I was pretty sure it was Monday for most of the day because this whole 3-day weekend really threw me off. But I'm going to go ahead and show you what I've been working on this last week. I'm still working on the same thing because it's really slow going, but I have only about, I want to say about 3,000 or so stitches left on my current project. Just a second. Alright, let me get into my bag of tricks here. This is my bag that I take everywhere. It's got all my cross-stitch supplies. Okay, so what I've been working on for this last week is that horrible, horrible thing that shouldn't be mentioned, and I don't know if you'll be able to tell what it is. Maybe you will, I'm not sure, but... yeah, so that's the project so far. Not going to talk about it again, just for... polite society. And then today when I was at work, I realized that I forgot my cross-stitch needle at home because I have this problem where when I cross-stitch on my couch, and so I stick the needles in the arm of the couch and go and do stuff, and I just forget about them, so I didn't have any cross-stitch needles with me. So I decided to start on a punch needle project, and I'll show you that. What I did, I just went and found a stencil online, and then I traced it. I held my punch needle fabric. Let me pop this up. I held my punch needle fabric up to the monitor of my computer and just traced it. And I'm going to try and show you the, I don't know if you'll be able to see it, but there should be light pencil marks. And you punch on this side, and then it results in the cool sort of texture on this side. It's going to be cute little brass knuckles. Punch needle project there, and yeah, so that's pretty much what I've been working on just this week. I've had a lot of ideas, but just not enough time to go forward with them. And then Opa Jen, she was talking about button making, and yes, I do have a button maker, and I find it extremely addicting, but I'm always just sort of low on ideas and everything like that, but I thought I would show you how I make some buttons, so hold on just a minute. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and show you how I make buttons with my simple button maker. It starts out with this little clampy thing where you just pull the lever down and it clamps all of the pieces together. To make a small button, there's these metal different set of rings and just all these different little items. And then for the larger buttons, there's these. It's pretty much the same thing but plastic. And the way you do it is you just pretty much put it together and then clamp it down. So I'm going to go ahead and take this this comic book. It's from Free Comic Book Day. Thank you to Heather for getting this for me. It's the Wolverine comic, and I'm going to go ahead and pretty much when you make a button, you can use the template. There is a program that I got, but instead I'm going to just use my, this is my small circle cutter. I just, you know, put this on the page, turn it around, and it cuts the circle. For the larger buttons, there's this one, you just turn it, and then you have your larger buttons. So we're going to go ahead and make the smaller button with this little bit from here. It's going to say BAM! Okay, so I'm just going to put it on my cutting mat in between the pages and center it how I want it. Okay, and then it cuts this neat little circle. Oops. That's okay. It's all good. Okay, so I have this little BAM. So go ahead and take this aside. Alright, so then we go ahead and take this blue piece right here. And then we have our miscellaneous button pieces. This is going to be the button, metal button front. And just put that in there. Then put this BAM right on top of it. And then take this gold piece. Oh, just kidding. I almost forgot, like, the most important part. You take the little clear plasticky thing. You probably can't see it, but it's there. And you put it on top of the image. And then you put the gold thing onto there. And just snap it in there. And then we take the silver one in there. The green one in there. Press down. And then we have the button pushed through there. So then we take this red piece right here, and we put this on top of here, press down on that, Then we take our button back, just the regular button back thing, and set it down into there. Then take the green one again, put it in there, then turn it over, and then we're going to go ahead and put it in the clamp. So we got it in there, and the difference between the larger and the smaller is this little piece you put in there just to make sure it gets it all the way down. So then we push the clamp down, we take this out, and then all of this falls apart, and we have a perfect little bam button. It's got its little pin back. Bam! And that's how I make a button. Okay, so I've messed this part up a million times, so I'm just going to say thanks for watching my video, and I'll see you next week. Bye.